Hello, Dean Worley, Dean Guder, and Dean Kramer. And hello as well to any other South Texas College of Law faculty member who is involved in this decision-making process. My name is Alexandra Maria Velarde, and this is my formal appeal to you all so that you may consider my readmission into South Texas College of Law. I am appealing through this video because I am currently out of the country on a previously planned trip, and I will not be back until August 1st. I am currently in a position that no one who aspires to become a lawyer would ever want to be in, and I want you all to know that I am determined to get back on the path to success. Perhaps looking at my grades might make you doubt that I have the ability to succeed as a lawyer, but I want to assure you that this is not the case in my situation. Self-representation might not be the best idea in a court of law, but in this situation, I am representing myself and advocating in my favor because I believe in myself, and I hope that I can convince you to believe in me as well. The grades I achieved are not an accurate representation of my abilities. I have always been a dedicated student and achieved an above average GPA when I graduated from Texas Christian University. My LSAT score of 154 is also an above average score. While these are grades and scores that I obtained prior to attending South Texas College of Law, I believe that they are an accurate representation of my intelligence, capabilities, and dedication. I have learned that things are not always what they appear to be, and I assure you that this is true in my situation. My poor grades might lead you to believe that I am not capable or that I am not putting in the effort, but neither of these things are accurate. I am a hardworking student who does her daily readings and takes meticulous notes before and during each class. I am attentive while my professors are teaching, and I credit many of them for making my passion for the law become even stronger. While I have many positive attributes that can make me a good lawyer in the future, I also have negative ones that I have been fighting to overcome for years. I am a person who was diagnosed with anxiety at an early age. I had learned to live with it by occasionally working with a psychologist because I did not want to take medication. I was unprepared for the effects that the pressure of law school would also have on my physical well-being. I was prepared to succeed during my first semester of law school, but my anxiety got the best of me. I had severe chest pains during the week when I had most of my finals, and I was not aware of the fact that they were due to my anxiety. I had to go to the emergency room because I feared that I was having a heart attack and even had to postpone my criminal law exam. My EKG results showed that there was something abnormal going on with my heart, and I was unable to focus on my exams after the scary news. Unfortunately, my grades were a reflection of a student who was distracted by a personal situation. I went to a cardiologist later on who told me my abnormalities were due to my anxiety, and that even if I had symptoms of a heart attack, it was not the case. It was difficult for me to believe him when my chest hurt in a way that I had never experienced before. My finals of the spring semester made me even more anxious because I had already messed up so badly the previous semester. I have had time to reflect on my 1L year and work on my health and well-being. I have been working more often with my psychologist, and we both feel that I am stronger and more capable than before. I have realized that I get anxious because I care too much about becoming a lawyer and I do not want to fail. I can assure you that I will continue to work with my psychologist twice a week and will even consider medication if I feel that the sessions are not helping me enough. With a 2.210 GPA, I am less than 0.1 below the required GPA. I am pleading with you so that you will consider letting me continue my studies at South Texas College of Law. I would accept any probationary conditions or any extra work. I cannot imagine myself doing anything other than practicing law. It is such an integral part of my family, and I do not want to give it up. My father and so many of my cousins are lawyers. One of my cousins, Alex Gonzalez, attended South Texas College of Law and inspired me to apply when he told me about how academically enriching his time at South Texas College of Law had been, a fact that I confirmed when I studied my 1L year at South Texas College of Law. My sisters also want to become lawyers one day. My dad never pressured us or even suggested that we follow in his footsteps, but simply watching him do his job so passionately made me want to follow them. I understand that the first year GPA is correlated with bar passage rates, but I want to assure you that I am capable of doing better. I was a qualified candidate for South Texas College of Law when I was admitted, and I still am now. Thank you so much for your time and consideration.